Okay, everybody, today we are going to make a river and do some texturing. Okay, so I've got my UEFN open. I'm just going to hit done on this intro page, head into island templates, and this time we are going to use the mountain ridge island empty. Now, you don't have to do this. You can start from blank, but we're going to do something that's kind of interesting. So let's hit create. And what this is going to do is it's just going to make a default. If you don't give it a name, you don't have to give it a name. We're just practicing. But we're going to make just this default sort of project. Okay, so the project has been created. And what we need to do is get down into this land as fast as possible. So you could try to navigate, like try to scroll in, or you could try to use the camera to kind of go in. A lot of times it takes a lot of time. So what we can do is just do right click and snap view to object. Bam, in we go. Okay, so it didn't take me where I wanted to be. So we're just going to use the camera from this point. And I've got my camera set to a speed of 6, and it's still going to take a little bit to get over to where we want to be. What I want to do, or show you guys how we go about doing, is create a river that goes from the top lake down to the bottom lake, way down to the left. So the one to the right, to the left, we want to make a river. Okay, so the easiest way to do that is we head into our content drawer, and that's just down at the bottom. If you want this to stick, hit the dock in layout button, and that will dock it in your layout. It makes your viewport a little bit smaller, but it's no big deal. Click on Fortnite, click on environment, click on water, bam, we are in. That's going to grab a river and just chuck it somewhere where you can kind of see it, right there. Okay, so it's going to modify our terrain a little bit, but don't sweat that. If we needed to make a change later on, we will. Okay, so let's figure out how rivers work. Rivers are actually reasonably simple. We can do an awful lot with them. First thing we need to know is the direction they're going in, because you want water obviously going downhill. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab the little gizmo at the end here, and we're just going to go over to, let's grab it so it's not grabbing one of the arrows. Just take it over down to the bottom lake, and then we'll zoom out a little bit. Just come out, and we'll grab the top gizmo. And it's not this one. This is the handle to this point. And this is a spline. So the spline is what is going to be able to, for our purposes, I'm just going to come out of here, is going to set the path of the river. So let's grab this guy and take it all the way over to this lake. Now, it's kind of funny to look at it like this because you can see how it's gone ahead and made this big cliff. So we don't want that. So we're just going to come over and twist around and come around. I'm just using the arrow keys and the mouse at the same time. We're just going to take this and we're going to bring it all the way down to the edge here. And it's still kind of funny. So let's try again. Come all the way down, point ourselves upwards, bring this guy down with the Z axis, so the blue axis, grab the green one, which is Y, and the red one, which is X. And now we've kind of got something, so I'm just going to bring this up. Let's zoom in a little bit. Let's come in a little bit. And I want to just make sure that my lake up here is draining kind of nicely. So let's come out a little and just take a look. Actually, I think that looks pretty darn good. I don't think I need to do anything else. See this handle that's way out here? I'm actually going to, let's bring it in a little bit. It's really stretched out. So we'll go all the way over here and we'll just grab the Y and just snag it in a little bit. I'm just using the arrow keys to move over, bring that in, just so it's not so stretched out. And I'm just going to have that like that. Okay, so how does that look? That looks good. It looks like the lake is just coming out of there. And we can see how much of a curve it's got. So we're going to grab this point on the spline and just move it upwards away. And this river currently is set to modify the terrain. And that's okay. That's fine. We're going to keep it like that. Instead of making our own terrain, we're just going to let Unreal Engine sort out what we want. Or what it should, what it thinks should, what it thinks the surrounding land should look like. Good. So that's kind of coming in nicely. You know, I think what I'll do is I'm just going to move this point here. Or is that a point? Is that the point? That's the point. Yes, because the handle is way out over here. So let's actually grab this handle and just move it up so it's not so stretchy out there. And that'll make a little more gentle of a curve. If you see here, if we move this handle here up this way and sort of stretch it out, it's going to move it and make sort of a wider curve. Actually, you know, let's leave it like that. Let's bring this guy over this way a little bit. I don't want it going into, okay, let's come up. And so, yeah, let's bring it over a little bit with the Y, just like that. Yeah, that looks a little bit nicer. Okay, so this is just how you move a river around with these splines. You can add splines too. So we right-click here. We can add a spline point right here, and this will then create that little point there. So we can actually have it come way out over here and just make that, make a curve all the way down. And if we really wanted to sort of get a bit interesting, we can take this point here and go like that. And that'll create a bit of a curve in the river here. That's kind of neat. It's going to come out and around and into this. Okay, so let's take a look at it from top view. So we can go to perspective and then go up to top. And you can see it kind of goes funny like that. Just hit it. Just change it to lit. And then we just need to go in. All right. So that's pretty good. So I'm just using the right mouse button. And I'm just looking at that thinking, yep, that looks pretty good. Let's head back to perspective. And that's nice. Now, the next thing we want to do, once you get a little river going like that, so you're moving your spline points around, you're getting it looking the way you want with the handles. You got your handles coming out like this. It just makes this nice curve. If this was a 3D program, this would be called a curve. And yeah, that's good. So the next thing we want to do is we want to, see if we look here really closely, we can see that there's still grass underneath that water. And that's not very realistic. So let's go into landscape mode up top. And we're going to go into paint mode here. And this map already has some paints sorted out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose mud. So you just click that. It'll turn blue. Make sure you have sculpt and paint layer selected. If you have this water layer selected, it's locked. So the little lock here, you can unlock it if you want to. But it's good to keep your layers pretty organized for where things live. So the sculpt and paint layer is here. That one's unlocked. We're going to go ahead and sculpt. Or sorry, we're going to paint, not sculpt. So we can zoom in a little bit and take a look at how our river looks here. And we're going to use mud and probably some, I think we'll use some gravel too. So check out your brush size. I've got mine set to 512, which is not very big. My brush falloff is 0.7, which is a very large falloff. If we bring this way down, then it becomes so much sharper falloff. But I want a nice wide fall. I'm going to put that maybe 0.5 or so. And then my tool strength is 0.3. So the brush strength is 0.3. So this is pretty good. And so we're just going to come along and we're just going to paint the texture in the river, so that it's not grass. And this is a very simple way to sort of make things look a little bit more realistic once you've created some water. All right, so just come over this way a little bit and take a look. That looks pretty good. Let's come up this way. And we just want to head all the way up the river like this. Now, I'm not going to bore you with going all the way up the river. We've got our mud in here, and that looks just about right. Let's zoom out a little. Yeah. Come back in, and you can see that this grass is, if we just kind of click really quickly, even at 0.3, it's taking away all that grass. But you can kind of leave a little bit of those weeds in there if you really want to as well. Okay, so now that we've got a little bit of mud sorted out here, this is how we texture the ground. We're going to grab some gravel, and let's see, let's put a little bit of gravel just on this edge here. So I'm just dragging with the mouse along here. And that's going to sort of set up a shoreline of gravel. And if you want to, you can even, you know, you could even kind of go a little bit there, just along there to that edge there, and just bring that over. And that gives us this sort of gravel edge to our river. Because maybe it's eroded away a lot of the material as it's running. And it's just leaving all these little bits of rocks and gravel and stuff like that. So, and that's looking pretty nice. I like that. Yep. And we just keep on going along with that. It's going to come along here, and then we can grab some more mud. And that's the simplest way to sort of go ahead and texture the ground to match how you make a river. And you just kind of continue on with that to make things look a little bit more realistic, because obviously grass is not going to grow inside of a river like that. So hopefully that's been kind of interesting on how to use a river, how to do a little bit of texturing on the ground. And we'll see you guys in the next tutorial.